Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Peter Ustinov, and I've got a secret.
I've Got a Secret, brought to you tonight by Bristol-Myers, makers of Bufferin, the modern drug that brings relief from headache pain, protects against stomach discomfort. Bristol-Myers brings you America's number one panel show, I've Got a Secret, starring Garry Moore.
Thank you so much. Good evening, and welcome to a special Thanksgiving edition of I've Got a Secret. Forthwith, I would like to introduce the members of our panel, who are, of course, Bill Cullen, and Betsy Palmer, and Henry Morgan, and Bess Myers. So, assuming now that we are ready, willing, and able, may I welcome our first contestant, please? Will you come in? All right. Leave room for Big Daddy. Here we go. Now, I'm going to ask each of these young ladies and gentlemen, to introduce themselves by name, please. If you want to giggle, it's all right. She's been giggling all night. She's the giggler in the group. What is she? All right, now we're going to be very serious. Now, you look at me. Look me right in the eye. No giggling, right? Keep looking.
I knew I'd get her sooner or later.
Tell him what your name is.
Cheryl Rollet.
Cheryl Rollet, yes.
Davy Arroyo.
Davy.
Barbara Briggs.
Barbara.
Gwendolyn Brown.
Gwen.
Francine Laporta.
Francine.
Lois Jones.
Lois.
Gay Lippman.
Gay.
Wilfred Pantoja.
Wilfred.
Vincenza Corrado.
Francesca. All right, now that we all know who we are, these children are students at PS 80 here in Manhattan. They share their secret with the entire student body of that school, and they are here tonight as representatives of the entire student body. All right, now, children, if you will whisper your secret to me, we'll show it to at the same time to our audience at home. You all ready?
Here we go.
Panel, the clue to their secret concerns something they did, and I think, Betsy, we'll start with you tonight, if you don't mind.
They did.
Something they did.
Miss Lippman, you have a basket in your hand. Does that have to do with anything that you did, all of you? The basket that you have. I can't see what you've got in your basket.
Well, we will show you. There are oodles and oodles of fountain pens. Now, the fountain pens are not mentioned in the secret. Their presence here tonight will be explained later.
Well, now, this is something that you did, ladies and gentlemen. Did you do this because of tomorrow being Thanksgiving?
No.
Did you do this for the rest of your fellow members in school?
Yes.
You did.
No, they did it with the
with
rest
them,
of
With them, but
their...
not for them.
No.
You did it for somebody outside of the school, then?
Yes.
All right, $20 down, $60 to go. We go, please, to Henry Morgan.
Well, do the pens have anything to do with writing? That you did, some writing you did.
These particular pens, no. Nor is there any writing, Henry, mentioned in the secret.
Did you, I take it the whole school did this same thing?
Yes.
Did you leave school to do it?
No.
Did you, have anything to do with people on the outside of the school?
Let's not say people, let's say person outside the school.
Somebody in the government, perhaps?
No.
$40 gone, $40 to go. Bess Myers.
Was this a child, perhaps? Someone your own age?
Yes.
Could it be somebody who lives overseas?
Yes.
Is this some kind of philanthropic endeavor?
Philanthropic? That means that you do it? Is this a favor that you did for somebody?
Yes. Did you perhaps collect pens and sell them and raise money and do something nice like that for some little boy or girl overseas? Yes?
All right, $60 down, $20 to go. Bess got almost there. What do you suppose, Bill Cullen, it was that they did for a single child somewhere overseas?
Well, it's almost unfair after Bess set it up.
I don't know what
but
they did.
But is it possible that PS80 has adopted, become foster parents for a child overseas?
Exactly. As I said, these young people here are representatives of the entire student body, and I thought it might give us something to think about tomorrow, and we're all sitting down to a big, fat Thanksgiving turkey dinner. They did adopt and are supporting a child in Korea. What's the name of the little girl in Korea?
Lee Hung Young.
Lee Hung Young. Now, we have a picture of Lee Hung Young right here. And, Cheryl, you want to hold that for me, please? I kind of got my hands full. And there is the little girl of whom they are foster parents. Let's hold a little more toward camera. That does it. Yeah. So, here, these people at their young age are parents already. This little 10-year-old girl was adopted by these children through the Foster Parents Plan headquarters here in New York. And the wonderful thing about this plan is that everybody gains by it. For example, this young lady here in the picture receives money and food and clothing through the contributions of the children of PS 80. And they, in turn, have an opportunity to exchange letters with this young lady here every month. And I have some excerpts from some of the letters that are written. Don't expect anything explosively funny. They're just cute. Sentence here and there from letters. I am going to tell you about my teacher. She is very nice. She always gives us homework to build up our minds. The latest is the preamble to the Constitution. I hope what I wrote about the Constitution will help you in school. I hope that you love us as much as we love you. Another excerpt. Have you ever heard of a Chinese restaurant? That is a lovely question to ask a child in Korea. We are getting a new president, and he will tell all the people what to do. Out there now, you know what to expect. We go to school at 8:30 a.m. We have many projects. Many people live in projects.
True. Very true.
I would like to tell you about what we learn in social studies. Columbus discovered America in 1492. After he died, there came a man named Americus who discovered America again. In October, we celebrated Columbus Day on October 12th. The tallest building in the USA is the Empire State Building. I hope the sun is still shining in Korea. Well, the project, which has proved to be quite educational, is the brainchild of PS number 80, Mr. Sidney Sinkoff. Now, the best part about the whole thing is that the money to start this project was raised initially by the children themselves. Francesca, how did you raise the money?
By selling pens.
You bought the pens at one price and sold them at a little more money, huh? Well, now, Gay back here has a big smile and is a pretty good salesman. I think he went to work on the panel. You might be able to get sell him a pen apiece. What does the pen sell for?
15 cents.
15 cents. It can't be too much profit. Why don't you go give them a try? They're a bunch of skin flints, but, you know, give them a
here
try.
Here we go. I know it. The barring starts. Help yourself there.
Right. Sure.
I'll tell you what.
Gay, dear.
We'll give you $5 for
two
pens.
Oh, stop. I got a dollar. You can don't show off. No, that's not right.
I'll give you $5 for two pens.
Right.
Come on, Henry.
Did you give the $5? No, you didn't give it a
Henry,
five.
I will, too. I'll give
come on, Henry, get it
big,
up.
Big.
Come on, $10.
Here's $10.
Very
we want, two, one.
here's $20 for one pen. There you go.
Well, now, wait a minute, friends.
Wait a minute. Here's $20 for nothing.
I often wonder at the end of the year, if we've had three or four spots like this a year, whether the boys ever do really get to collect from the girls on the panel.
We take them out to dinner.
I haven't. We've been
Sunday.
And I said I'll drive them home tonight.
That's we've right. been on the air for 8 years, and I haven't collected from Henry yet.
All right. Thanks, panel. Above all, youngsters, happy Thanksgiving. You should be very happy with what you've done. Good night. Now, did you ever notice people's hands when they're under tension? There are the nail biters and the finger drummers and the fist clenchers and so on. But on one of these bad days, when just nothing seems to go right, hand exercises aren't much of an outlet, and tension can build up and grip you with a headache and maybe tight nerves and a jittery stomach. So what can you do about that? Well, here's what I do. I take two Bufferin, because Bufferin fights these three effects of tension. It relieves tension headache fast, It relaxes tight nerves, fast, and it calms a jittery stomach, fast. Now, that's a mighty good combination to have working for you when you want pain relief. And that must be why doctors recommend Bufferin by name more than any other leading brand of pain remedy. So, next time you feel a headache coming on, you take my advice and take, as I do, two Bufferin. They'll do it for you every time. All right, now, panel, I want to tell you that we're about to meet our next contestant, who happens to be a gentleman who you know professionally rather well. May we have the curtains open, please? I'm going to stop sooner or later.
Yes, I trust so.
Yes, we'll just bring it right down here. There we are.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Now, this gentleman who is jumping the Thanksgiving... Oops. Who is jumping the Thanksgiving gun by about 18 hours is Frank Corbin. And Frank, as the panel knows, is the vice president of McCarty Associates, the public relations firm that handles press relations for I've Got a Secret. Frank, it's very nice to have you with us on our stage.
It's very nice to be here, Garry.
I should think so. Look at what
yes,
you got.
Delightful.
Turkey looks delicious. May I have a bite?
Oh, I'm very happy to have some.
Thank you very much. Now, in addition to the turkey, he also has a secret. So if you'll whisper it to me, we'll show... No, take that if you like. It's not polite to whisper with your mouth full, but here we go. Tell me what your secret is, Frank. Panel, the clue to Frank Corbin's secret concerns something he is going to do, and we will start, please, with Betsy.
Frank. This isn't by any chance the turkey that Henry Morgan brought back from England, and you're going to fly it back again for this Thanksgiving.
I sincerely hope not,
Betsy. Goose? Well, this might be a goose. Well, has this anything to do... I know none of that stuff is from my refrigerator. Because I just started... No, mine isn't cooked yet. I just stuffed it today.
It might be yours.
It couldn't be. I will shoot you all if it is. I really will. This, what you're going to do, has it got to do with anything which is before you right now?
Yes, in a way.
Has it to do with the food, and us?
No, not really.
All right, there's $20 gone, 60 to go, and we go, please, to Henry Morgan. It's a candid yam, Betsy.
Frank, is there any point in our particularly watching you eat? Will we find out anything from that?
One never knows, Henry.
But I don't think that you will.
Yeah, I'm the one who doesn't know.
From your refrigerator, any of it?
From my refrigerator? I got a 29-cent TV dinner in there.
He's got that and an old girlfriend who's keeping on ice for hard times.
That's true. That's upstairs. Well, that's the freezer compartment. You ought to get off that anyway. I saw a thing in the paper the other day, but I might as well throw it in because I don't know what he's doing. Really, yesterday's paper had a thing about a fire out in the West Coast, and it started in a refrigerator, and the story ended there. It just started in the refrigerator, period. You know, you look, how, what? Just thought I'd tell you about it.
Well, friends, welcome to Omnibus. $40 down, $40 to go. We go, please, to Bess Myers.
Yes, Frank.
Yes, Frank.
You're going on a diet.
How did you guess?
Is he?
Yes!
Oh!
You thought you were saying exactly the opposite of what the secret was,
no,
didn't you?
No, I made two notes that I thought were kind of funny. Uh-huh. Henry says, I'm never funny. And I said, one, Betsy was upstairs talking about this marvelous dinner that she prepared for tomorrow. I said, Betsy's dinner. And the second was, you're on a diet.
Well, you hit it right smack on the nose.
I'll tell you, if you're going to be funny, I'll turn pretty.
It's going to be easier for her to turn funny, Henry, than it is the other way around. Well, now, Frank, you had lunch or dinner, I guess, with the panel in a professional and social capacity, and at the every time that the dessert comes along, you hear Frank say, tomorrow I am going on a diet.
Right.
But his secret is that tomorrow, not after Thanksgiving, but tomorrow before Thanksgiving, he is going on a diet. Have you ever said that to yourself and really meant it?
Oh, many times, many times.
Well, tonight at long last, somebody is taking him up on it. Now, if you can stop eating for just a moment, I have an affidavit here for you to sign. The affidavit states that you will stick to the diet that your doctor prescribes. Now, how much weight do you want to lose?
Well, I should like to lose about 40 pounds, but I'd be happy to settle for 25 by my birthday, which happens to be the same as yours, January 31st.
Well, now, let's take you at your optimum. Let's take the 40 pounds that you hope to lose. Now, here's where we're going to work this out, Frank. You won $80 here tonight. That works out to $2 a pound.
Cost me more than that to put it on, Garry.
Now, we'll just hold the money for you at the office, and every time you lose a pound, we'll pay you $2. Eventually, in the end, we hope you get your full 80.
I hope so, too, Garry.
Meanwhile, my friends, we will let you know of Frank's progress as weeks go by so that you see that it can be done. We hope.
I hope so, too.
Meanwhile, it's not tomorrow yet. Enjoy.
Thank you very much.
And as Frank takes up with his Thanksgiving dinner, here is something to brighten up your outlook.
Such fun to be young. Fun to be grown up, too, especially if you know how to stay young gracefully. Her family adores her sunny appearance. The lively tone of her hair. Does she or doesn't she? Miss Clairol hair color looks so natural, only her hairdresser knows for sure. Yet just a few months ago, she made an important discovery while shopping for a new dress. Somehow, all the colors looked wrong. And suddenly she realized that her hair, which had always been her pride and glory, looked faded, dull. Yes, old. Now she uses Miss Clairol, and her hair color is young again. Fresh, sparkling, prettier than ever. Her hair in beautiful condition, and Miss Clairol really covers gray. So why grow old gracefully when you can stay young gracefully? Try Miss Clairol. You'll love it.
I have a small program side note. Naturally, after each contestant goes off, if he has a chance to talk to me at all, he wants to know, how did my spot go? How did I do? Do you think that it went over well? So I turned to Frank as soon as they went into the commercial, and I said, hey, your spot went very well. He said, I said, what's the matter? No salt. Well, now, my friends, it is time for us to meet a very special guest, a gentleman I've been looking forward to meeting for a long time, the distinguished English actor, playwright, author of the wonderful picture book called Ustinov's Diplomats, and more recently, author of his first novel called The Loser, which received magnificent reviews all over the country. Here is Mr. Peter Ustinov. Speaking of reviews, as a matter of fact, today, I don't know how much you keep in touch with what's going on all over the country regarding your book, The Loser, but the Chicago Sun-Times today had a real rave on your book.
Oh, well, you saw it.
Now, you have brought along a secret tonight, so I thought if you will whisper it to me, we'll show it at the same time to our audience at home. Panel, the clue to Peter... can we switch to the panel for half a moment, please? Bill and Henry, I thought I knew everything about you, but as soon as we got the audience reaction, both of you did give me the gesture.
You're just imitating Peter.
Oh, I thought maybe new code signals had been worked out.
No.
Or something. Well, you know,
no, that was Peter going...
We're drying our nails.
All right, the clue to Peter Ustinov's secret concerns something that he is going to do, and Bess Meyerson, we'll start with you, please.
Peter, this thing you're going to do, does this have anything to do with Thanksgiving?
Yes.
Yes. Are we going to participate with you in any way?
Yes.
Yes? Did you prepare dinner for us, perhaps?
No.
No.
All right, there's $20 down, $60 gone. Bill Cullen?
Peter, will it be done here on stage tonight?
Yes.
I can hear silverware.
Yes, I do, too.
You do what?
I hear
silverware.
Cutlery back there.
Oh, well, believe
I
you.
I hear cutlery and
no,
a touch
No, they're having
of...
the haircut. I just...
Oh. No, we did that.
Beware.
Are we all going to... How in the world could a fire start in a refrigerator?
And you know, the fireman came... It was in a restaurant, too.
I can't understand that. Incredible. That's something else, Peter. We shouldn't even do this. Are we all going to join in the Wassail Bowl? which is one of America's leading football games.
No, I'm afraid not. $40 down, $40 to go, and we find Betsy Palmer, who finds herself nowhere.
Yes.
What a silly night, isn't it?
Peter, does this have anything to do with...
Don't talk
many
to him
of
unless
your...
he looks more interested.
No. Of many of... I don't blame him for not being interested. Nobody asks him anything, poor thing. No, seriously, does it have to do with any of your talents as a writer or as an actor or as a director or with Romeo and Juliet Knopf or whatever it is?
It may do by the time we've finished, but not at the moment.
Romanoff and Juliet.
Yeah. What was it, Romanoff and Juliet off?
Romeo and Juliet
off. All right, $60 down, $20 to go, and so we go, please, to Henry Morgan.
Now, you ask the question.
Yes, Kooky, dear. Dear, are you, the last...
Dear?
You, I was talking to him. I said Kooky, dear, not to him. He's just plain Kooky. You're Kooky, dear. Kooky, what was established? Oh, it's about
I'm
Thanksgiving.
I'm waiting for the question mark.
Yes, does it have anything... does it have anything to do with eating, in any sense of the word?
By implication, yes.
Are you cooking tonight?
No.
Is it anything to do with recipes?
No.
Is food involved at all?
Yes.
Is anyone going to eat it?
But that depends on how appetizing it is.
Is someone other than yourself going to prepare it?
Yes.
All
right, panel, we've blown the $80. Would you tell the panel what your secret is, please?
Yes, well, Garry, when I received your very kind invitation to come on a Eve of Thanksgiving show, I decided to concentrate on an aspect of Thanksgiving which is not generally, it's generally neglected.
Oh, what is that aspect of Thanksgiving?
Well, I studied many historical documents on how to cut a turkey.
How to carve. Well, panel, you'll be happy to know that Peter Ustinov has unselfishly offered to share his recently acquired knowledge of carving with you. His secret is that he's going to teach each of you how to carve a turkey. Now then, before we proceed, and as a public service feature, I would like to have a word with all the ladies in the audience. If your husband is asleep in the next room, wake the bum up. Get him in here because he can learn something. Tell him to write down and take notes because many fine and novel ideas are going to be presented on how to carve a turkey. Betsy.
Well, excuse me for interrupting you, but I don't think we girls should learn how, because then if we learn how, then the men will never do it in the family.
Yes, that's the way it works in our house, and I'm glad. Can we open the curtains, please? If we open the curtains, you will find that we have a 25-pound turkey for each of you. Now, go up there. You will find labels with your name on them up there. Stand behind the turkey of your individual designation. Oh, yes, do take off your gloves, Betsy. It's so sloppy otherwise, you know. All right. Now, Mr. Ustinov, when the entire cast is assembled in place...
Yes.
He will give you the official word on the bird.
We're using the standard style tonight. There's a side style and there's an eastern grip on the... Oh, those are complications which we won't go into. You've all got a knife in front of you, each one of you. And you should wait for it. Sharpen it. In the approved... That's a very nice, easy style on the end there. Right, we'll take those as being sharp. Now, to remove... To remove the leg, thigh, or second joint, and
you
drumstick.
My fork.
Are we going to be serious now?
Yes, we are.
Of course we're going to be serious. I wouldn't kid around with a thing like this.
Hold the drumstick firmly with the fingers.
With the fingers?
Pulling gently away from the turkey's body. Yes. In other words, on a Pierce arrow, that would be in reverse. Wait a minute. Yes. Put that back again, Bill. Stick it over.
Hey, Gary, you better make some announcement about
continue
where the food's
follows.
Going, hey, because we've got a lot of complaints, you know.
Yes, we're going to announce later on in the show that the food is not going to waste. It's all going to go to a charitable institution, will be eaten and
remember
enjoyed.
Remember that.
Wait, mayo. All right, what do we do with it?
You put that on the plate.
What are you doing, Henry? What are you looking for?
I just
want
to see what's in there.
Running ahead of you.
Henry, come on, second joint. Truly.
Next.
I got two joints.
Cut through the joint. Well, you're very lucky. You cut through the joints.
One of them's running at a loss.
Leg to back, bone and skin on the back. You've all done that.
Yes.
Hold leg on service plate.
I've got it.
Why? What? You know how to do it.
Hold leg on service plate with drumstick at a convenient angle to the plate.
And then we slice.
Separate drumstick and thigh by cutting down through the joint to the plate or through the plate. To the plate.
Come on, Henry. You're going to have to do it tomorrow night. Somebody's house. Cut. There, I've got it. Okay.
Then you cut into the white meat parallel to the wing.
There is no white meat on a leg. Anybody
say that's pretty silly. There's white meat on my leg.
Dark meat off if you want it.
No, up here now. We're on the body.
Drop that out. That's open. Actually,
you must find my place here.
Why don't you find your place there?
Ready?
Peter?
I don't have it in me to ruin it, you know.
Well, don't. It'll not be ruined. It'll all be enjoyed.
If I do it, it'll be ruined.
I think we should, in reference to Peter.
The last line is important. Additional turkey may be carved as needed.
Let's get an additional turkey.
Well, I must say that in reference to Mr. Ustinov's book, we should choose one of these people as the loser, but I think they're all losers. If I were you, I'd go to the automat tomorrow. Eat out. Don't kid around at all right?
Beautiful.
I'm sure it's awfully good. Peter Ustinov, thank you ever so much for being with us tonight.
Peter.
Well, how long have you known how to carve?
4 minutes.
He never carved one in his life. So, until tomorrow, then, maybe we wish you happy Thanksgiving and goodbye.
Goodbye.
I've Got a Secret will be brought to you next week at this time by Winston Cigarettes.
It is a most curious thing, and a quite revealing thing. All these filter cigarettes, they all look alike, but they do not smoke alike. Smokers know the difference between Winston and all the others. One reason is here, Winston's modern pure white filter, the most popular of all. But that's only the beginning, because it's what's up front that counts. And that's where Winston takes an extra step to give you the purest kind of smoking enjoyment. What's up front is Winston's exclusive filter blend. And this is what filter blend means. It means Winston's tobaccos are not only selected for their flavor and mildness, but also specially processed for filter smoking. This is Winston's secret. This is filter blend. And filter blend is what makes Winston taste good, like a cigarette should.
Miss Meyerson's Gown by Cameo. Bristol Myers also brings you Candid Camera. Consult your local listing for time and day. I've Got a Secret has been brought to you by Bristol Myers, makers of Buffrin. For relief from headache pain, and by Miss Barrow. Her color's so natural, only your hairdresser knows for sure. This is John Cannon speaking.